For a while, I was thinking about, you know, I want to do something do something positive in this world. And so it took me a little time to figure out what that was going to be. And JJ had already created a couple of brands. And so I'm thinking, well, maybe we can create a brand. And, you know, so once we decided that, we were like, all right, what's that going to look like? What's it going to be about? Right.
Sunshine beating on the good times, moonlight raising from the grave, string band playing worn at honky tonks, pretty young thing going dancing in the rain.
All right, hey, what's up? This is Free Rein's first podcast. Fucking really excited about this. I'm Maynard Fisher. This is JJ, my son. It's Christian Cole. We're all partners in Free Rein, and these guys do a lot of our content, and so we're just now getting started in this podcast world, and we're ready to kick ass. So we're going to talk a little bit about our story, where we came from, how this started, and then just kind of talk about shit, you know. Just, so we started this like almost two years ago. We were, I remember it was 2021. I was just tired of the news and tired of the bullshit and tired of the divisiveness and tired about just a bunch of crap. So I stopped watching the news, and for a while I was thinking about, you know, I want to do something do something positive in this world. And so it took me a little time to figure out what that was going to be. And JJ had already created a couple of brands. And so I'm thinking, well, maybe we can create a brand. And, you know, so once we decided that, we were like, all right, what's that going to look like? What's it going to be about? Right.
Right.
And to be honest with you, that was, about that time was, wearing masks every day and people were getting vaccinated, and I don't judge people for wearing a mask or getting vaccinated. But I was feeling at the time, like I didn't want, like I hated wearing a mask. Right.
Right.
I'll wear it to be responsible around people that are vulnerable. Right. So no big deal there. I didn't want to wear it every minute of my life, and I certainly didn't want to get vaccinated. People want to get vaccinated, that's fine, but I didn't want to be forced into it, right? So I remember the mask part of it is really where Free Rein came from, because, you know, Free Rein one of the meanings is that it's an unbridled horse, you know, and they're just riding without the bridle and riding free, right? So I remember having conversations about and it just felt right, like this is it, this is where we're going. This is Free Rein. And so so that's where we started, and then we just have evolved, and we took about 6 or 8 months where we were kind of stumbling around trying to figure out what we were gonna do and how we were gonna do it, and, you know, learning a lot from JJ because he had created brands before. And so and then we started taking on some partners, and we went from a LLC to a corporation, and then we added talent like Christian and Tyson, and so we've got several partners. We're American owned, we're minority owned, like we have black owners, female owners, like we're as diverse as you can be, right? Yep. And so we represent America to its core, and we're all about freedom. That's all we're about. We want positivity, all about freedom, living the way people want to live, as long as it's responsible and respectful. Yeah. That's all. That's what we're about. And so I'll let you guys add to that if I missed anything.
Yeah, I mean, I remember, starting out in the living room, just us talking about what we were dealing with, what everybody was dealing with at the time, and just sitting there like, you know, what can we do to help? What can we do to kind of make sure shit like this, you know, doesn't happen ever again?
Yeah.
And start, you know, brand was the idea. Side by sides was in there. And I just remember like, hey, I think we can, you know, take it to a different level. Like we might as well add dirt bikes and add the hiking and camping, the farm shit, like the shit that we're kind of already around and our friends do and we do, and
yeah,
you know, just, you know, so many people that we can touch with this. And
yeah, being an outdoor brand was natural to us, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, so the outdoors and motorsports was what we chose, and it's been pretty fun.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, I remember even, obviously you guys started everything before I even, you know, I came around. And so I remember whenever first meeting you, JJ, we were shooting stuff for Underworld, like shooting some skateboarding stuff. And I had like really had no idea, you know, what the brand was, or that even JJ had even started or anything. And I don't know, just kind of working with him more. And
Yeah, that was a cool transition going from the streetwear. Like, hey, dude, like, this shit's fucking boring. Like, you want to come do this other shit we're trying to do?
Yeah.
Yeah, he was like, you want to come take some pictures of me riding a side-by-side? Yeah. I was like, yeah, absolutely. What are you talking about?
Right. Yeah. So we got Zane, you know, JJ and Zane are brothers, my boys, and Christian and Tyson and Brent and Nick. And we've had a couple others that friends that joined us. And now we're getting ready to... Shit, we're paying out for all of our content, and we decided, mm-hmm. you know, they're great guys, but you know, we think we can do good work on our own, and so we cut ties with them, although they're still friends. And so you guys have been doing most of our content ever since. That's probably been what, 8 months now?
Yeah, pretty much. I mean,
doing September
all the content.
Just, you know, we got that feeling like, hey, I think we can, you know, make all the content. We like making content. Like, yeah. I think we can just do it all.
Right. Yeah.
You know, so we got the Sony camera in and the lens, and Christian had his camera stuff. And like next week it was head out to Utah.
Yeah.
Start in Breckenridge, go to Moab.
First week. Yeah.
Bryce Canyon, Zion National Park, down to Grand Canyon, and, you know, hike and camp all those places with, you know, we came out with just tons of footage, drone footage, fucking, you know, camera footage.
And that kind of boring free rein media services, right?
So yeah.
So you got to talk about that. That's been exciting.
Yeah. I mean, it pretty much started at that, like, pretty much at that moment, you know, whenever we decided, like, to make that investment of ourselves. I remember I was talking to JJ before, while we were still with the last guys, and I was like, I want to do more video, and I want to do, you know, I want to do a lot more than just take pictures and edit, you know? And I was like telling JJ, I was like, bro, I was like, let's just get our own cameras. Like, creatively, JJ has like so much experience and has like such an eye for what he wants. And he's able to kind of, you know, put that together in a good way. And I was like, he just didn't have like the cameras and like the gear and like the actual camera knowledge to go do it. But I was like, I had the camera knowledge and like, you know, so we kind of like, bro, let's just throw it down and do this together. Like,
yeah, I've been kicking ass ever since.
Yeah.
Yeah. We've been a lot of places.
And we got a lot of GoPros now. Mm-hmm. Zane's got his thing going with his Jeep and contributing like that. And we got our apparel, and it's been a lot of fun. We've definitely been evolving. And now we got this space that we're looking at over Casey Moe.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's going to be fun.
Yeah. So we got a couple of friends over in Casey Moe that we're working with to, there's a building that is raw right now, but looks like it'd be really perfect.
It's bones right now.
Yeah.
It's got an elevator.
It's got an old elevator.
It's bones, but it's good bones.
Yeah. Event space, studio space, podcast space.
A few offices.
Yeah. Apparel. Mm-hmm. We can do all of our own apparel there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So it's going to be kick ass.
Hopefully have some screen printing stuff in there too.
Right.
Yeah. Have a bunch of fucking parties.
Yes, absolutely. A bunch of free range parties.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's going to be awesome.
Private events as well.
Excited about that.
Yeah.
Yep. You know, one of the things that I spoke to here recently, a couple of things, I'll say again what we did a video, or just me phone video. And I was telling an old friend that I had caught up with, and she's been talking to friends about free rein and out in Maryland, you know, DC area. And so she's telling this guy, that friend of hers, and he's like, well, you know, sounds like some redneck narrative kind of thing. And
fuck that guy.
Yeah. And I said, look, you know, I know this guy ain't even seen our stuff. So yeah. If he even seen Never our even stuff, he'd see it real quick. But yeah.
Fucking Maryland.
Really. So I just, you're right. I just felt compelled. I was like, I gotta get on the fucking phone and do a video. And
yeah.
So for everybody out there, we ain't a part of anybody's narrative. Nobody's. We are our own fucking identity. And we're about all of you and all of us, women and men, everywhere. Everywhere around the world. We're all about freedom. That's it, period. Yeah. So we're not a part of that divisive bullshit. We're positive. We tend not to get into politics or faith. But we do have our own opinions, of course. But we feel like we can have a conversation with people and disagree even. And still be friends.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. Yep.
And we think 100%. That's important. Mm-hmm. Everybody should have their own goddamn free right to what they think and how they talk. And as long as we're respectful and responsible people. So.
But I do know a few people that call themselves rednecks probably whip that guy's ass.
Yeah. I might whip his ass.
Go ahead and fuck around and find out.
Yeah.
Go fuck around and find out.
Oh, shit.
So, yeah, we've been moving pretty consistently since... since we started, met a lot of great people.
Learned a lot.
A lot of great people. Relationships and great connections and great trips. A lot of learning experiences and, you know, just us morphing as a team has been...
Right.
It's been a struggle, but it's been
it's
been the right struggle. So I trust it. And, you know, we thank everybody that's supported us up to this point. And we're excited to see where...
A lot of great partners out there.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mallet Belly and Dust Off Fishing and Preston and
Mallet Belly.
Yeah. Isn't that her?
That's her name on Instagram.
And Instagram, yeah. And she does crazy good things.
Yeah.
She's just kicking ass out there. Yeah.
Yeah. Tons of great people.
Yeah.
I can't wait for that. I think we're doing a float trip in July.
Yeah. That'd be awesome.
Have everybody together. So if
they'll be on the podcast eventually.
Yeah.
We'll definitely have them on for a few episodes.
Yeah.
Have more involved. So
now we're getting ready to do a podcast tomorrow and Righteous Tattoo out in Leavenworth, Kansas.
Yep.
That'll be
fun. Did my work out there. Yep.
Yeah.
Great people.
Yeah. Really good people. So yeah, it's going well. I'm really excited and it gets rough in spots. Of course, we're a new brand, new business.
So, yeah.
But Chip, I feel like we're doing really good.
Yep.
Yeah. Yeah.
But with the obstacles just comes more opportunity to learn and keep pushing.
By the way, shout out to Yingling. We were talking about
Yingling.
Yingling.
Oldest beer in the United States, and they finally made it out here. So we're happy
to the Midwest.
Enjoy their
sucking
brew.
Down that Yingling.
It's good beer. Oh, good beer. Yeah.
Yeah.
So, yeah. What else? What else we got on the horizon?
No, I think we pretty much covered the basics of it. I think we can... save some for the next time.
Go ahead, wrap it up.
Yeah, we'll see you next time. Free Rein.
Appreciate you guys.
All right. Be your freedom!